When we're scanning a medical record, in the typical process, what we're going to do, we're going to go through a lot of prep. So we're going to work through this document piece by piece, and we're going to try and create a nice clean pile ready for scanning. And then in areas where we've got dividers like this, where it says clinical notes, we're going to probably insert a barcode separator page that's then going to tell a piece of software like COFAX how to paginate the PDF. Because without doing that, you're just going to be, when you scan it, you're just going to be left with a big PDF that's a little bit unusable, or at least very difficult to use. We're obviously operating a zero prep approach, or at least a combined prep and scan approach. So we don't want to be inserting barcode separators as we scan the documents. So when I hit OK now, and I start scanning, I can drop in the cover sheet. That's then going to tell the machine, it's going to recognize that file type, it's going to tell the machine that we've started batch. And then I've got here clinical notes. So we just build onto the screen, just a button that the user can press. Can be an alphabetical list. I just hit clinical notes, very limited training needed to start scanning stuff like this. And then I just drop that on the track and I'm able to just continue with the scanning. That means as the operator, I'm now able to focus on dropping each item one at a time, and I'm performing some physical checks with my eyes and my hands just to make sure that the documents are going to be able to be ingested into the machine with ease. So you can see there's some items that are a bit dog-eared. I'm just going to unfold them as I go, rotate them around so that they're going to be fed with what we call the best edge first. And here we've got something that's really in quite a bad state when we're looking at scanning it. It's been chewed up, we've got bits folded all over, and it's really quite difficult to see. Now when I scan this, you can imagine that when a clinician comes to look at this, or someone who comes to make some decisions with this record, they may send this item back to be rescanned, because it's in such a bad condition. And we want to eliminate those rescans where we know they're likely to happen. So we build into the job a button that says PQO that allows us to say that we recognize that this was bad when it came in. As we scanned it, we did the best we could to get the best image we could. Again, eliminating as many of those rescan requests as possible. And when we come to prep something like this in a traditional environment, we're probably going to walk over to a photocopier, take a photocopy of this, produce an A4 copy of this to drop it down the machine, or we may tape this to a large piece of paper. In the OPEX world, I'm again just looking for that best edge first, allowing it to be pulled through the machine nice and easily. We have something like an envelope, like that, maybe that was on a ward, goes through, and here you can see it's rejected that and said, I saw more than one piece of paper. That's those sensors I mentioned earlier that are detecting air gaps between the paper, and it's detected this air gap here. So to override that, instead of changing a load of settings within the scanner, I just tap this little button, allows me to drop the item, it's taken through as a single piece, and I'm allowed to just keep feeding items as I go along. This also is separated here with different bits hanging off it, so I just drop that through and it's fed okay. Another item that's been taped up and repaired many times, I may just want to say again, I think this is likely to be requested for a rescan, so I'm just going to press the PQO and focus on the next item, because that's the approach we want to take. We want to make sure that our focus isn't so much on paper as it travels through the machine. We're focusing on the next item in front of us and making the decision around that one. Here we've got what is essentially a three-dimensional object. It's an inhaler container. And in a traditional environment, we're probably going to cut this up, flatten it out, maybe take a photocopy of it, or again, sellotape it to something else. In our world, I just need to flatten that out, interact with the machine again, and drop that through. I'm going to trust the software is going to do the work for me in terms of orientating it, making sure it's presented in the right way. So now I'm just going to continue to build in the taxonomy of operations and endoscopy in this case, and just start feeding the documents through one at a time, performing those physical checks with my hands and just looking for anything that might be adhered, stuck to the paper. Again, I've spotted staples here, there's some other bits. Because I'm dropping these one at a time, I'm able to perform those checks. And because the scanner is so kind to the documents as it takes the paper through, I don't need to worry too much as long as I understand the limitations of what I can get through. Here I'm just switching to investigations and results. So as I'm going, as I'm talking to you guys, I'm able to build in that report, build in that what would be bookmarked on the PDF, making it nice and easy. Here we've got an ECG. So ECGs can obviously get very, very long. This machine will comfortably take three pieces of A4 as a single piece through the machine, but ECGs can obviously get much longer than that. In those instances, a decision has to be made about where it's appropriate to cut them. We've made the decision of around this size, so now I can just drop those through the machine one at a time, and then I can potentially build in a button that's going to say these are ECGs, they've likely been cut up, and then they can be stitched together post. We have another envelope here. Again, I'm just going to interact with the machine as I continue to feed the documents piece by piece. So when you're looking at prepping medical records for a high feed scanner, you're probably going to be able to prep the documents when you're including the barcode separators and everything at somewhere close to 300, 400 pages an hour. And if you're really fast, you may get up to something like 600, you know, if you have a really well-defined process and you're very used to handling medical records. Even now, as I'm talking to you and I'm going what's normally pretty slow for scanning medical records in our machine because I'm stopping and I'm talking and I'm explaining things that go along, I'm now hitting quite comfortably 800 pages an hour with barely breaking a sweat in terms of how quick I'm feeding these documents down the track. And that can be expected almost straight away. So when you're comparing a combined prep and scan, I'm already scanning and prepping together here quicker than a traditional prepper would handle these documents. We just move on now to the final subsection within the record, the miscellaneous. Drop these items in just like this. And you'll see content out there, people doing this much, much quicker than I can. But even as someone who's not, doesn't do this day in, day out, I'm already hitting 900 pages an hour quite comfortably. So here you've got something that may need to be scanned in color for whatever reason. So as you'll have seen, I can interact with the screen, I can interact with buttons around the machine to make that happen. But in some instances where we're going to have recurring decisions to be made, we may want to limit the amount of times the user has to reach over and press a button, and we can use pieces of technology like this. This is our multi-ID, multi-slot ID assist. So instead of pressing a button, I can just wave the paper into the tower like that, drop it onto the track, and that tells it to scan that piece in color. Or it can tell it to override the feed control or scan it to a certain set of settings, all without having to leave this general hand range. Means I, as the user, can again just keep focusing on getting that feed rate up, up, up. So here we've got an X-ray, and as you will well know, an X-ray is essentially a clear piece of plastic that's printed in black and to create a rendition of, in this case, the bones of a foot. So typically when we scan on our machine, it creates a black space behind any image, and you'll have seen that when things have been torn so that we can see that we're not artificially inserting parts of the image. But if we sort of drop this on the track, it would go straight through the machine because it's not effectively going to see anything. So to get around that, very easily, I just join it with a white piece of paper, stick that into a plastic wallet, and then I can build into the machine some settings that's going to allow me to make sure I capture this as best as I can. And that could be a button press. And of course, as I've got multiple sheets here, I'm probably going to need to use the override. But again, if I want to streamline that process, I can just instead use it as a swipe on the tower, drop that in. It's categorized as an X-ray. It appears on screen as an X-ray. You're obviously not going to make some clinical decisions based on that, but someone viewing this record knows very quickly which X-ray it was within the record. That allows me to then just scan that final piece, and I've completely scanned that medical record effectively. The software can be told that when it sees that final piece to close that and send it off to the next part of the process, be that ingestion into an ECM platform or something like that. Then we've got the primary care. So that was all secondary care, the type of documents you'd see within a hospital environment. When we come to primary care, so the GP notes, a lot of them consist of these Lloyd George envelopes. And these, again, present all the same challenges of the normal medical records with a few extras. So because this is just a small wallet and everything that's gone in this has been in sometimes really stuffed in here and it gets all full, and then it's been sat at the back of a GP surgery or in some kind of storage environment for upwards of 50 years, when you bring the paper out, it's very difficult to try and scan it in a traditional environment, because what you're going to do when you come to prep this is you're going to create a nice clean pile, or at least you're going to attempt to, of paper that you're going to feed down a track at a high speed. But because this paper has been sat in an envelope for so long and it's in such a difficult state to manage, high stack feeding this becomes instantly very, very difficult. But because in the OPEX world, we're not doing that. I'm taking these pieces and feeding them one at a time and just doing some light touches with my hand to make sure that we're going to go through the machine nice and easily. And again, I can build in all those extra functions. I can say that this needs to be scanned in color. I can turn off the feed control if it's got things stuck to it. It means that I can take a Lloyd George envelope, take the contents out of it, and digitize this stuff really, really easily. Very little prep work needed. And we'll even get another one of those inhaler boxes down. That just leaves us with the Lloyd George envelope itself. So again, these have to be treated a little different because of the property of the state, as many of you will know. We can't destroy this just like everything else we normally would. So a decision has to be made about what we're going to do with this. And this usually involves an extraction piece. And once we've scanned it, we're going to take all of these out and decide what we're going to do with them separately. A good opportunity to do that is at the point of scan when you're using the OPEX. Because instead of having everything put into the same bin like this, in this instance, I've just created a button that roughly matches the color of a Lloyd George envelope. I can feed that through the machine and tell that when you scan a Lloyd George envelope, we're going to be ejected into this bin at the back. So then as I continue on to the next one and the next one, the records are all scanned, but the Lloyd George envelope are all collected at the back.